morning students, this is the second topic of lesson number 1, evolution. As we have seen, for evolution there are different definitions in the science. What is evolution? In simple, it is the gradual development over a long duration. Two words are very important. Gradual development means the sudden change is not there. Before many crore years ago, there was no life on earth, and now there is a complex organisms, variety of complex organism present on earth. So how this happen? This is not happening suddenly. It takes some time, or this process is called as a therefore gradual change over a long duration, many billion years ago. How this process started, and now we are looking around us, there is a different variety of organisms. So this is nothing but called as a evolution. So different theories of evolution are there. One by one we will see them. First we will see what is the theory of evolution in the beginning. It is said that before 3.5 billion ago, there was no life on the earth. After that, in ocean, there was a simple element found. From that simple element, organic and inorganic compounds were formed. And after many years, slowly, gradually, that organic inorganic compounds come together. For example, proteins, vitamins, nucleic acids, these organic inorganic compounds, minerals like phosphorus, magnesium, these all come together, organic inorganic substances, and they form complex compound. Now these complex compound come together to form first type of primitive unicellular cell. For example, cell like amoeba paramecium, which consists in cell wall, cytoplasm, nucleus. This type of cell, first primitive cell, unicellular cell arise, and from that unicellular cell, multicellular organisms are formed. Now this is the simple how the process of evolution has started, and still now also evolution process is going on. Now we will see what are the evidences. What is the meaning of evidence? Evidence means on which basis we can find out certain differences and similarity different in between different organisms, that are called as a evidences of evolution. For example, it is said that reptiles or mammals are evolved from reptiles, amphibians are evolved from fishes. So what is the main basis? What is the main basis for that? We will see that is called as the evidences. So there are basically 6 evidences are given in this lesson. In that, first evidence is morphological evidence. These all evidences are asked for the short note. Morphology means what? The word itself suggests external characters. Study of external characters or external characters expression is called as a morphology. If we have seen in the textbook page number 4, there are pictures are given, different types of organism faces are given, nose position, nose, ear, eyes position, all this position if we observe in dog, donkey, horse, the nose, ear position is same. So this morphology is similar. So it suggests that as they are morphologically similar, they may have common ancestors, they may have common origin. So this evidence is called as a morphological evidence. Second evidence is anatomy. What is meaning of anatomy? Study of internal characteristics. What are internal characteristics? For example, structure, bony structure. If we have seen in the diagram 1.5, structure of bones is given. If we see cat's forelegs, human hand, different types of diagrams are given, flipper of whale, patagium of bat, these all diagram, 1.5 diagram on page number 4, if you observe, internal bony structure is similar, but their function is different. For example, human hand function is different for pulling, pulling, or different types of functions are there for human hand. Similarly, flipper of whale, its function is different, it is used for swimming. Although their bony structure is similar, but their functions are different. It suggests that their internal bony structures are same, but their functions are externally different. This evidence suggests that their ancestors are common or their origin is common. Now we have seen what is meaning of anatomical evidence is that as they have similar internal structures but different function of that organ, they may have common origin or common ancestors. The third evidence is that vestigial organ. The word vestigial is for waste organ. waste means nothing but they are not useful now, but they were useful in initial stages of life. For example, different examples are given. Appendix. This bone appendix, that is called as a coccyx, COCCYX coccyx, this bone appendix is present in all human beings. Initially, it was used for digestion of raw food when people were living in the forest. And in search of food, they were eating raw fruits in that region, in that period. They are using this appendix for the digestion of raw food and fruits. But nowadays, as we are taking cooked food, so it is not useful nowadays. So appendix goes on now disintegrate or degenerate. These disintegrating organs, or slowly they are disintegrating from our body. These organs not useful now, but they were useful in initial period of time. These organs are called as a vestigial organ. So what are these vestigial organ? Wisdom teeth. They are present, but they are not so much useful as they are present very behind in our mouth cavity. They are only present, their usefulness is very less. Different examples like ear muscles. So these are the examples of vestigial organs in the human beings, animals. These organs are present in our body but not so much useful. They may be not useful in human being, but they are useful in other animals. So these organs are called as a vestigial organ. Presence or absence of this vestigial organ is one of the evidence for the evolution. On the basis of this, we can find out. Fourth evidence is palatological evidence. Meaning of palatology is the branch of biology which deals with the study of fossils. Fossils means underground buried that bony structures before many years ago, whatever that bony structures are there, they are called as a fossils. By the study of that fossil, we can identify which organism. If we take a vertical section of the land, different layers are there. On that layers, which animal is present, at which level, and which is at the bottom, which is above that, and which is at the top. According to this vertical section of the earth's surface, and on the study of that fossil, we can find out which organism is evolved from which organism. So at the bottom, that organism that is the original, and from that next organism is evolved, and above next stages are there. So this is helpful palatological evidence. This is called study of fossil, and according to that find out which organism evolved from which organism. This is called as a palatological evidence. In that, carbon dating method is very important. Carbon dating method means, once Willard Gibbs, the name of scientist, he first time find out there are two types of carbon consumption in our throughout the life. For example, whatever food we take in our daily life, it mainly consists of carbon. So carbohydrates consist carbon. It carbon is mainly two types, C12 and C14. C12 and C14 ratio is always constant, but after the death, consumption of food is stopped. Now this ratio of C12 and C14 goes on changing. Why this changes? Because C14 is radioactive, it goes on disintegrate, and C12 is non-radioactive, C12 remain as it is. Because of this, C14 goes on decreasing, C12 remain as it is. The ratio of C12 and C14 do not remain constant, and according to this ratio, we can find out how much age of that fossil. This is called as a carbon dating method. And this method was given by scientist Willard Libby. Now the next is connecting link. What is meaning connecting link? There are certain animals, if you observe their characteristics, we can find out they are certain link. They are showing characteristics of two main groups. For examples are given duckbill platypus, given on page number 4. Given on page number 6, duckbill platypus is the connecting link between mammals and reptiles. Mammals, because they are showing mammary glands and hairs like mammal, but they are laying eggs like reptiles. So duckbill platypus is example between connecting link between mammals and reptiles. This suggests that mammals are evolved from reptiles. Second example is lungfish. Lungfish respire by lungs, but it is fish. So it is the connecting link between amphibians and fishes. Third example is peripatus. peripatus showing open tracheal system like arthropods, like cockroaches, insects, it show open tracheal system, and like annelids, like earthworm, it shows segmented body. So it is showing segmented body and open tracheal system, which are characteristics of two different groups. They are shown by the same organism. So peripatus is a connecting link between arthropods and annelida group of animals. Now the last evidence is embryological evidence. If you observe human being, cow, horse, dog or donkey, different types of embryological changes are given. Embryological evidence means what? If we study embryological, page number 7, embryological evidence, stages of different animal. Initial two stages are showing they very similarity, and third stage is showing differences. This suggests that cow, fish, salamander, tortoise, chicken, pig, they all have a common origin, as their initial stages of embryological are very similar, and afterwards the changes are there. So these are the six evidences of evolution. It may be asked for short note or separately or in common. Long question will be there, detailed question will be there. Explain different evidences of evolution. First is morphology. Externally they are similar, but internal characters are different. Internal. Second is anatomy. Internal character, bony structure is same. Third, vestigial organ, disintegrated organs which are not useful in certain animal, but they may be useful in another animal. Fourth, palaeontological means study of fossils. In that, important thing is carbon dating method. C12-C14 ratio is always constant, but it goes on changing after the death, as C14 is radioactive, goes on disintegrating. So this is one important method to find out the age of fossil. After, next is connecting link. Certain animals which are showing different characteristics of different group, they show that which animal evolved from which animal, which organism. Last is embryological evidence. Initial stages of embryology are similar, but afterwards they goes on changing their different characteristic. It shows that they have different ancestors, or they have common ancestors or origin. So these are the different evidences of evolution we have covered in this topic.